Pathways are a part of the general education requirements for students at University of Buffalo, and this video is a quick overview for C's students. All links are in the description. You can Google UB Pathfinder tool or follow the link, and I've already created an example. Engineering students choose courses of interest for these four, any that look interesting, and then specific classes that apply towards your engineering or computer science major for these, as they overlap with the major anyway. Like for mechanical engineering, they're MAE 494 and 451. And if I bring up the dynamic flow sheet for mechanical engineering, we see those two courses as part of the degree anyway, regardless of choosing as pathways. Either way then, mechanical engineering students would choose these MAE courses, electrical engineering choose the EE courses, civil engineering CIE, etc. Computer science students choose five general courses, and the thematic list three being the major specific CSE 442. You can find all the C's majors with the pathway choices here if you'd like help knowing what the department abbreviations stand for. And see this like for biomedical engineering, and those are the ones you'd pick for pathways, and here they are applied as an example. Or alternatively, if you want to do a foreign language track, you just choose a language track of interest. So to quickly summarize, if I go to Global Pathways here, there are three main areas. Most engineering students choose Global Reflections, where you can just pick classes. But the second here is International Experience of Studying Abroad. And you can always update your pathways if you decide to do this later on, and the final option is to choose a foreign language sequence. As far as the thematic, choose any topic that looks interesting, and then just go through the lists and choose classes that look cool to you. And you'll find the relevant engineering or computer science class in list three. Like this is what an electrical engineering one chosen looks like. Be sure then to save to hub. That's it. If you don't have any pertinent AP or college classes that you're transferring in, also bear in mind that you can always change your pathways later. If you have transfer credit or AP credit that has been processed and in the system, you can find them here under the course filter. This student has three eligible pathway courses, so when choosing thematic pathway, we see the eligible options right here at the top of each area. And we can just scroll down and choose them as we go, resulting in using all three in this case across thematic and global. If your credit isn't processed yet, you can always return to the Pathfinder tool here and make changes. That's it. Thanks for watching.